Hi guys, in my last video where I was discussing why I hate Spurs, there was a moment in that video where I hit a bit of a stumbling block when I started to talk about trainers. So, like I said, I don't be one of these people that stands on the side of the arena knocking someone's riding, but with this lady in particular, I don't know who she is. Get rid of those Spurs, get rid of that whip. You have to change trainer because your trainer isn't your trainer. I'm not the trainer either. I mean, but something's very wrong here. Now the reason for that is because I would have been going completely off topic if I was about to start talking about trainers in general. Now there are different. Different ways people use trainers. Now the most common way is the trainer's there when the owner is riding and the trainer is on the ground giving instructions, but quite often trainers are booked to ride the horse, which, you know, it's very normal, fair enough, and the owner at times might not even be there. So I didn't want to spend another few minutes then talking about, you know, the things trainers get up to, because it would have been going completely off topic. But because I paused there and said and just explained it as there's obviously something very wrong here, it wasn't to knock the trainer. Now that horse has been trained to a good standard. Regardless who is riding it in that video, I can tell that that's a really nice horse and someone's done a really good job with that. And I just had concerns that a trainer might seem me and the way I just stopped what I was saying as me knocking the trainer, but I absolutely wasn't. I've had no negative feedback or anything like that, so I'm not making this video for any other reason than just to say sometimes if I stop saying something it's because I know I'm going off topic. Now the other thing that can happen is that trainers can actually tell a rider, look, you're not good enough to do this, we need to work on that. Not to be negative, but they always balance it out with something positive, of course, but there are some riders out there that might not take that sort of information in a positive way and perhaps even change the trainer. And sometimes it's unfair for the trainer to be brutally honest with an owner because, you know, they're earning a living from training, they need to put food on the table and they've got bills to pay. But sadly, more often than not, trainers can encourage their client as much as possible to improve in certain areas, but whether it's just down to the client whether they take that information on board or not. So that was the reason I stopped what I was saying yesterday, and when I watched it back it might have come across as I was about to knock the trainer, and it that couldn't be further from the truth. I know a lot of trainers and I know they work really hard. So there would have been, I don't know what the situation was in that specific case, but there could have been a million scenarios revolving around the relationship between the rider and the trainer, and obviously I have no way of knowing what that is. So, but in my experience, there are good trainers, there are bad trainers, but most of the trainers I've met have been very good. And I certainly can take criticism from trainers because I'm paying for that criticism, and that is something a lot of riders need to take on board, that if you are paying a very good trainer, I mean, I want the truth, I want the bare truth, no matter how much it hurts, because once I know the truth and where I'm going to improve, then we can start taking steps to reaching that goal. So, hope that was helpful. See you soon, bye.